Welcome to lecture number 15 of this course on analog MOS circuit design. And in this particular lecture, I'll be talking about different types of MOS amplifier. In fact, over the last few lectures, I've been talking about the common source amplifier and the common gate kind of amplifier. Now, in this particular lecture, I'll be talking about the third variant of it, which is known as the common drain amplifier. Now to start with, let me just show you the simple structure of a common drain type of amplifier. So here the input signal is applied at the gate of the MOS device, and the output is obtained from the source. So these are the three terminals of the MOS: gate, drain and source, and we are applying the input at the gate end, Vin, and we are sensing the output from the source end. So we have a resistance over here, RS, and you are sensing the output over here. And the drain terminal is connected to power supply line, which is VDD. So this particular circuit is the simplest model of a common drain topology. Now, before going into the further details, let me just show you the qualitative behavior as exhibited by this particular circuit. Now, let us assume that here at the input side, the input signal has been increased by some amount, and let this enhancement is given by delta V in. So initially the input was at V in, and then it has been increased by some amount, say delta V in. Now when this happens, we are interested to observe the nature of the output signal, which is sensed at the source end. Now there could have been three different possibilities for this output signal. First possibility is that the output signal will remain as it is. The second possibility is that the output signal will increase. Or the third possibility is that the output signal may also reduce. Now let us assume that the output signal is constant. So what we find, the input signal is applied at the gate and the input signal is increased by some amount, delta V in. So the gate potential has been increased. So this is the fact, and let's assume, so our assumption is that let's assume the source potential, which is the output potential, suppose this is constant, even if the gate potential has been increased or the input signal has been increased. Now if I just combine these two events, then what happens is VGS, the gate to source voltage difference, that must increase. And as a matter of fact, the corresponding drain current, which is flowing through the device, it will also increase. Because we know that the relationship between ID and VGS in the saturation region is given by half mu n Cox W by L into VGS minus VTH whole square, and if you'd like to include the channel length modulation, then 1 plus lambda VTS term will be there. So assuming the device is in saturation, then the drain current will increase with the corresponding increase in the gate to source voltage. Now if the drain current increases, then obviously the voltage drop across this resistance RS will also increase. So it implies that ID times RS will also increase, and which is nothing but the output voltage, that is V out. So it implies that V out will also increase. So our previous assumption that the source potential is constant or output potential is constant even if the input signal increases is proved to be invalid or false. So if the input signal increases by some amount delta V in, the output signal will also increase by some amount. And let this increase is given by delta V out. And we are interested in finding out the corresponding change, and which is known as the voltage gain, given by delta V out upon delta V in. So this is the qualitative analysis of this particular structure. Now, in order to find out the exact expression for the voltage gain, we have to take the help of small signal model of this particular circuit. Now, this particular circuit involves a MOS device and a source resistance. So therefore, let me just change the color and draw the corresponding small signal model. So we have a three-terminal device, gate, drain, and source. And let's assume that between gate and source, the corresponding voltage difference is equal to V1. So obviously, we should have a voltage-dependent current source between drain to source, whose value is given by Gm times V1. Now, for the time being, let us assume that the lambda is equal to 0. That means we are just neglecting the channel length modulation. So between drain to source, the output resistance is absent, R0 is absent, or we can say that R0 is equal to infinite for the time being. And between source to ground, we have this resistance RS. It's connected like this. And we are applying the input signal between gate and the ground. So the input signal is applied between gate and the ground. And we are sensing the output at this particular node, V out. And here you can see that the drain terminal is connected to the power supply line VDD. So therefore, in the small signal model, this drain is connected to AC ground. So this is all about the small signal model of this particular circuit. Now we are interested in finding out the relationship between V out and V in. So to do that, what we can do is we can apply the KCL at this particular node. Now let's assume that this current, which is flowing through RS, let this be I out. So this I out can be written like I out is equal to V out upon RS. And if I apply KCL at this particular node, source node, then what we find, there are two currents. One is I out, second one is Gm V1. And as far as the direction is concerned, it's quite obvious that Gm V1 is equal to I out. That is equal to V out upon RS. And we can also apply one KVL between this particular loop, which suggests that V in is given by V1 plus V out. So now let me go to the, let me just put it over here. So what is V1? V1 is nothing but V out upon Gm times RS. So V1 is given by V out upon Gm times RS plus you have V out. So let me go to the next slide. What we obtained is V in is given by V out upon Gm times RS plus V out. So if I take V out common, then it is given by 1 by Gm RS plus 1. So therefore, AV, the voltage gain as obtained from this circuit, is given by V out upon V in, that is equal to 1 upon 1 up by gm rs plus 1, which is equal to gm rs divided by 1 plus gm rs. Or this can also be written like rs divided by 1 by gm plus rs. So from the expression of the voltage gain AV, which is obtained like gm rs divided by 1 plus gm rs, so this is quite obvious that the voltage gain is always less than unity. The value of AV is always less than 1. And if I consider that gm rs is much greater than 1, so AV less than 1 always. So this is always true. And if I assume that gm rs value is much greater than 1, under this condition only, AV can be approximated to be 1. But it cannot reach 1 exactly. It can only be approximated to 1. That means, in other words, I can also say, if I just observe the expression like this, rs upon rs plus 1 by gm, then if the value of rs is much greater as compared to 1 upon gm, then only the value of AV can approach unity. So it can approach unity if and only if the value of RS is much greater than 1 upon gm. Otherwise, the value of AV is always less than 1. So initially we have called this particular topology as a common drain kind of amplifier, but ultimately what you find is, if I once again go back to the previous slide, ultimately what you find is, if the input signal is having a variation from Vin to Vin plus delta Vin, that means if the fluctuation is by delta Vin, then the output signal will also increase by some amount delta V out, but the value of delta V out is always less than delta V in, because the expression for the voltage gain says that the amount of AV is always less than 1. Now, as far as our conventional notion of amplification is concerned, we know that if the input signal is having certain fluctuation, then the corresponding fluctuation will be magnified at the output end, but which is not true in this particular case. Rather, what we can see is the input fluctuation is almost replicated at the output side, because the value of delta V in and the value of delta V out being almost same, if I consider the AV to be close to 1. And moreover, there is no phase difference between input and output. So we can also say that the output signal, which is sensed at the source terminal of the MOS device, is basically following the input signal which is applied at the gate. So that's why this particular topology, apart from a common drain amplifier, it is also known as a source follower circuit. So this is a common drain topology, because the drain is considered to be common to both input and output, common drain topology or common drain amplifier. Because if I just closely observe the small signal model, we can find that the input is applied between the gate and the AC ground, and the output is obtained between the source and the AC ground, and drain is at AC ground. Therefore, we can say that the input is applied between the gate and drain, and the output is obtained between the source and drain. So that's why it is known as a common drain amplifier. And after we analyze the circuit, then we have found that the input signal variation is almost replicated at the output side. So we can say that the source terminal is going to follow the input signal. So that's why it is also known as a source follower circuit, for which the gain is always less than 1. So it's somehow related to a common collector amplifier, what you have studied in the electronic circuits course. There you have found that for a common collector amplifier, the gain for this particular circuit is always less than unity. So the next obvious question which must come into your mind is that, what is the necessity of using a common drain kind of amplifier? Because between these two terminals, if I call this terminal to be say point A and this terminal to be say point B. So between A to B, we don't have any sufficient gain. In fact, the signal is attenuated to some extent as far as the value of AV is concerned. So we can directly connect these two terminals by means of a piece of wire. Then what is the necessity of having this arrangement over here? Now to answer this question, we have to find out the other properties of this amplifier. So we have already calculated the voltage gain. Now apart from voltage gain, the amplifier is also characterized by its input and the output impedances. Now, if I observe the circuit once again, we find that the input is being applied at the gate terminal and the output is obtained at the source terminal with the drain terminal at AC ground or power supply line. Now, as you know, for a MOS device, the gate is isolated from the semiconductor substrate by means of an insulator. So, under low frequency operation, there is almost no current flowing between the gate and the channel. So, as a matter of fact, we can say that the input resistance is infinite, as we have seen for a common source amplifier also, in which case we have applied the input at the gate terminal. So Rn is infinite for low frequency operations. However, if you increase the frequency operation, then obviously we should have certain capacitors between gate and drain and between gate and source, and accordingly some amount of current can flow through those capacitors, and accordingly the input resistance, or under which case we can call it like input impedance, cannot be infinite. However, for low frequency operation, the value of Rin is infinite. So this is a straightforward approach to find out the input resistance. Then how to find out the output resistance? Now to find out the output resistance, let me once again draw the circuit, and we will be following the same strategy as we have done earlier. First of all, we need to draw the small signal model, and then we have to make all the independent voltage and current source to be inactive, and then we have to identify the output port where we need to apply some test voltage. So to start with, let's first identify the three terminals of the MOS, like gate, drain and source. Between gate and source, suppose the voltage difference is V1. So therefore, between drain and source, there is a voltage dependent current source whose value is given by GM times V1. And we have the resistance RS between source and ground. And drain is already at AC ground. Now, in order to calculate the output resistance, what you need to do is that we have to make all the independent voltage and current source inactive. Now, here we have applied some independent voltage source at the input side. So, I need to make this one inactive. So, how to make it inactive? I need to make it short circuited. So, therefore, this should be at AC ground. And then I have to identify the output terminal. So what is the output terminal? So output terminal is the source terminal. So accordingly, we have to identify this to be the output terminal, and we need to apply some test voltage between this output node and the ground, and let the current being drawn is given by Ix. Then the output resistance R out is given by Vx upon Ix. Now, from this particular circuit, it is quite obvious that V1 is equal to minus Vx. And if I consider that this current is given by, say, I out, then what we find is, if I apply KCL at this particular node, then we find that there are two currents which are entering the node, that is GM V1 plus Ix, and one current which is leaving. So they must be same. So GM V1 plus Ix is equal to I out, or Ix can be written like I out minus GM V1. So I out is nothing but Vx upon Rs, because this voltage is Vx and this resistance is Rs. So I out is nothing but Vx upon Rs, and GM V1 can be written like minus GM Vx. So ultimately it will be plus GM Vx. So if I take Vx outside, then it is like GM plus 1 upon Rs. So this mathematics says that Ix upon Vx, which is the reciprocal of the output resistance, is given by GM plus 1 upon Rs. So this is nothing but the output conductance. So how to find out the output resistance? So it suggests that the output resistance Vx upon Ix is given by the parallel combination between Rs and 1 upon GM. Because the conductance, they are added together, so therefore the corresponding resistances will be in the parallel combination. So the output resistance R out for this particular circuit is given by the parallel combination between Rs and 1 upon GM. Now normally we know that the value of 1 upon GM is in the range of few hundreds of ohms, not more than that. So therefore the value of R out is generally governed by this 1 upon GM, because this is typically small with respect to Rs, which is the source resistance, and therefore the R out is typically governed by 1 upon GM. So for this particular circuit, this common drain amplifier, we have already found that the input resistance is infinite and the output resistance is very small, in the range of few hundreds of ohms. So what is the advantage of using this particular circuit? Now let me just give you an example. Suppose we do have, let me consider we do have a common source kind of amplifier like so. With no source degeneration, the input is applied at the gate. We have some RD, and suppose the value of RD is given by 500 ohms, and we are obtaining the output over here. Let's consider that the 1 upon GM for this particular circuit is given by 50 ohms. Now we know that since it's a common source kind of amplifier, so the expression of the voltage gain, if I just consider the modulus of that, that is given by GM times RD, and which is nothing but 500 divided by 50, that is equal to 10. It looks nice as long as you are measuring some open circuit output voltage. Now suppose this particular stage is followed by another low resistive path. For example, we are feeding the output, this particular output, we are feeding this particular output to some antenna for which the radiation resistance is typically small, in the range of say 50 ohms. Then what happens? So we have one antenna which is identified by its radiation resistance, And suppose this value is given by 50 ohms. Now the open circuit voltage, we have calculated the value to be V out. Now as soon as you connect this low resistance antenna, you are loading the amplifier by means of this antenna, then obviously the output voltage that we are supposed to get over here is given by the input voltage multiplied with the gain of the circuit, and this time the gain is not equal to gm times rd. Rather, you find that between drain and AC ground, we do have two parallel resistive paths. One is through rd and second one is through rn. So now it will be modified like rd parallel rn. So what we find is we have some gm and the value of rd is typically large, say 500 ohms. Now when this 500 ohm is coming in parallel with 50 ohms, then the effective resistance is governed by the minimum of these two. So if I just want to calculate the value of V out, then it becomes V in multiplied with, so we know that the value of GM is equal to 1 upon 50, and if I calculate the parallel combination between 500 and 50, then it will become 500 into 50 divided by 550, and the value of GM is given by 1 upon 50. So ultimately, what you find is that means 10 upon 11. So 10 upon 11 multiplied with Vin. So now if you calculate the voltage gain, so that gain seems to be less than 1. Initially, without this resistance R and we have a sufficient gain whose value is given by 10. Now once we connect this low resistance at the output of this particular circuit, we find that the voltage gain drops down significantly from 10 times Vin to 0.9 times Vin. So the notion of amplification is completely lost whenever we have connected a low resistive path at the output of this particular circuit. Now to get rid of that, what is done? You have this circuit. Let me just change the color. So we have this common source stage. Like so. With RD is equal to 500 ohms, for example, input is applied at the gate with GM is given by 1 upon 50 ohms, or 1 upon GM is given by 50 ohms, and we are collecting the output from this particular node. Now instead of connecting this output directly to this low resistive load, what we are doing is we are applying this input to another stage of amplifier, for which the input is applied at the gate and the output is sensed at the source, and here we are using that resistance R and as the source resistance or the output resistance. So as you can understand, the second stage is nothing but a common drain topology, and ultimately we are sensing the output from that particular node. And let me consider, this is my intermediate voltage. Okay, right? So this stage is a common source stage, first stage, and second stage is a common drain stage, CS followed by CD. Now, what happens over here? As you know, this V out upon V in can be written like Vx upon V in multiplied with V out upon Vx. Now, will there be any change over here, Vx upon V in? Now, here at this particular point, this Vx upon V in is given by, obviously we have some minus sign. So in fact, we have forgot to mention some minus sign over here. We should have a minus sign because we are dealing with a common source kind of topology. So Vx upon V in over here, as you can find, is nothing but minus Gm times Rd parallel the input resistance of the common drain stage, and which is typically very large. We have just now mentioned that this resistance is ideally infinite. So this Vx upon V in can be approximated to be minus Gm times Rd. And what about V out upon Vx? Now, in order to find out V out upon Vx, we have to take the help of the analysis which we have done right now. So this is nothing but Gm times R ant divided by 1 plus Gm times R ant. So what is the value? R ant here, suppose we are using the same value, that is 50 ohms. So Gm R ant is nothing but unity. So you have 1 over here divided by 1 plus 1, that is half. So ultimately, this V out upon V in, what you obtain over here, is nothing but minus Gm times Rd multiplied with half. So Gm Rd we have already calculated, that value to be 10. So now this is coming out to be minus 5. So instead of using this R ant directly to the output of this common source stage, what we are doing over here is that we have connected this output to a common drain stage, which is acting as a voltage buffer and which can drive the low resistance path. And accordingly, the gain has been increased to some extent. Without this Rant, the open circuit voltage gain is given by 10. And as soon as you connect this R and at the output of the common source stage, the voltage gain drops down significantly. Now, instead of connecting this R and directly to the common source stage, if this is driven by one common drain stage, then the overall output voltage or overall gain can be obtained as minus 5. So we can consider that this particular topology, a common drain topology, will help in reducing the loading effect to some extent. Now, in this entire analysis, we have neglected the channel length modulation. Now, let's have a look what happens if the channel length modulation is not neglected. So, under this condition, let me once again draw the circuit diagram itself, which is something like that. Input is applied at the gate, output is sensed at the source. So far we have neglected the channel length modulation. So if you don't want to neglect the channel length modulation, then what happens is, so this is the source terminal. Between gate to source we have V1, and between drain to source we have this dependent current source, voltage dependent current source, Cm times V1, and the resistance is there between source and ground. Drain is already at AC ground. Now the output resistance is basically connected between the drain and the source terminal, just like this, RO. That means this resistance RO is connected in parallel with this RS, because RS is connected between source and AC ground. And since for this particular topology, the drain is also at AC ground, so therefore we can consider that R0 is connected between the source and the AC ground, and we are supposed to obtain the output at this particular node. And we are going to apply the input over here. So it's quite obvious that the expression of the voltage gain says that. So we have got this expression like this, RS divided by 1 upon GM plus RS. So that can also be written like, so RS is nothing but the total resistance. In fact, that expression is true for the previous circuit without considering the channel length modulation. So this is the total resistance tied between source and the AC ground. That is all about RS. Divided by 1 upon GM plus total resistance tied between source and the AC ground. Now this condition is true, or this expression is true, with lambda is equal to 0. That means R0 is equal to infinite. Now if R0 is not equal to infinite, that means if lambda is not equal to 0, then what about the total resistance tied between the source and the AC ground? We have one resistance RS over here between source and AC ground, and another resistance R0 is there between the source and the AC ground. So therefore, in the numerator, instead of having simple RS, now we have RS parallel R0. And here in the denominator, we have 1 upon GM plus RS parallel R0. So accordingly, the voltage gain will be modified to certain extent. And the value of the voltage gain as obtained with this particular inclusion, that lambda is not equal to 0 or R0 is finitely large, then the voltage gain will drop down. So AV will be less, will be reduced to certain extent. So if I want to include the channel length modulation, then the value of the voltage gain will be reduced to certain extent. And as far as the output resistance is concerned, we have seen that previously the output resistance is given by the parallel combination of two resistances. One is RS and second one is 1 upon GM. Now with channel length modulation, now output resistance calculation, if I quickly look into the output resistance calculation with channel length modulation, then we find that this is gate, this one is source, this one is drain. Between these two, the voltage difference, say, let it be V1. And we have one dependent voltage source like this. RS was there between source and ground. Gate is grounded for the output resistance calculation. Drain is always grounded for common drain topology. And what we have? We have the resistance R0 connected between the source and the AC ground. And this terminal is the output terminal. And what we are doing over here, we are just connecting one test voltage at this particular node. We are just connecting one test voltage at this particular node, and we are measuring the current. We are measuring this current Ix, and R out is given by Vx upon Ix. So we are not going to do the same calculation what we have done previously. We can observe that in the previous calculation, we don't have this R naught in parallel with Rs. We only have this GMV1, we have this Rs, V1 over there. So everything was same. Now this time a new inclusion has taken place in the form of R naught. And that time we have seen that with lambda is equal to 0, R naught was absent because these two terminals was open circuited. And with lambda not equal to 0, we can readily find out that the output resistance can now be written as a parallel combination of three resistances. One is Rs, second one is 1 upon Gm, and since R0 is connected in parallel with Rs, so the output resistance will be given by this. Now typically the value of R0 is large as compared to Rs and 1 upon Gm. So therefore, even if the channel length modulation is included in this particular calculation, then the output resistance is once again governed by the minimum of these three, and which is nothing but 1 upon Gm. That means even if I include R0 over here, the output resistance of the MOS device, the output resistance will not be altered significantly, and it is governed by 1 upon Gm, and which is typically very small. And for a MOS amplifier, we can consider this value to be close to 50 to 100 ohms. So in this particular lecture, I have talked about the common drain topology, the calculation of the voltage gain, and the input and the output resistance. So over the last few lectures, I have been talking about the different types of topology of a MOS amplifier, including common source, common gate, and common drain, with different types of loads for common source in particular. For example, we have considered a simple resistive load. Moreover, we have also included the current source type of load and diode connected load, and we have obtained the expression for the voltage gain for different cases. So our time is almost up, and with this I would like to conclude this lecture session on MOS amplifier.